ranked undefeated Louisville Cardinals face perhaps their biggest test in 2013. 4-1 Central Florida is in town. Ranked undefeated Louisville versus Central Florida on Friday night. Short kickoff taken by Rennell Hall to near the 30-yard line. 6'4", 230, now a junior. He's developed into a good one. Play fake on first down, bobbled in.
Accurate. He's got enough mobility, too, to make you miss.
His best games were against Penn State and South Carolina. Had a career high in the South Carolina 3-point loss. Play fake again on second down. This time complete, goes right back to J.J. Warden, who is laid out.
Up, didn't go high, didn't lead with that helmet to helmet. Unfortunately for J.J. Warden, ended up hitting him there.
Storm Johnson, first carry for the junior running back from Loganville, Georgia. That's Teddy Bridgewater. He gets the football next. UCF driving on the opening possession for the Knights. Tipped and incomplete. It's one of those things you're always advocating.
Absolutely.
Your good friends, the defensive ends.
Yeah.
Bortles rolls, finds Storm Johnson, who has room to run. Big block on the outside to send Storm Johnson inside the loop.
Got that vibe. It's going to be a physical ball game tonight.
The first and only American Athletic Conference matchup between Central Florida and Louisville. Johnson, nothing on flick earlier from Calvin Pryor. Opening drive into the red zone for Central Florida. Storm Johnson.
A lot of different games. They like to play with the quarterback and the offensive line. Really disguise thing. Have a lot of guys standing around.
On third and eight to the end zone. It is tipped. Intercepted. It's Calvin Pryor who has the interception. An INT a week ago in the win over Rutgers. The big blow to drive by UCF, and now an INT in the end zone.
Did he keep his foot in bounds? Man, it looks like it was just in. You see it right inside the white paint. What an acrobatic play by Calvin Pryor. Both these safeties for Louisville, so impressive.
Does the back foot hit as he's juggling it out of bounds.
Foot in bounds.
Louisville's up to the line after the INT from Pryor. It's in the books now. Louisville football. Bridgewater flings to the outside.
Make sure it's way out of bounds.
So now it's Bridgewater and the Cardinals, both Sonoris Perry and Dominique Brown, joining Teddy Bridgewater. Play clock at 1:00. Louisville apparently gets it off. Looked like a lot of motion on the line as well with no
zone. Watch number 41 right there. Got an outstanding job. That jump, that's why the play was blown up.
And 3rd and 6. Out of the pistol. Bridgewater over the middle, right at the sticks. Big again, the terrific piece they ran just prior to this game about the inspiration they have offered one another. Bridgewater over the middle, it's tipped, almost picked.
Need to impress when they're on national television. People are watching. They need to win, and they need to win impressive. as much as you hate it, you think it's unfair, it's just the way it is.
On second down, this is Sonoris Perry, the senior. Bust through tackles to get the football on the INT in the end zone from Calvin Pryor. Rolling complete for another first down, Eli Rogers.
When nothing's there, do you check it down? Do you take your shots down the field? Got to be smart and set your team up in the right spot.
Louisville's best in the country, 64% on third down. 2 for 2 on this opening drive. On first down, flayed on the screen to Eli Rogers again.
Near backfield, knock him around. Even if you don't sack him, hit him as much as you can.
Teddy can take a pop. We found that out, yes, against Florida in the Sugar Bowl last year on that opening drive. Play fake, pressure, Bridgewater delivers, there's Devontae Parker. Gain for Parker, pushes Louisville to the UCF 22-yard line. Opening drive for the Cardinals. That's Sonoris Perry, one of three tailbacks that Louisville will use. He pushes inside the 20.
Bridgewater, as he transitions to the NFL, whenever he does decide to go there, it'll make it that much smoother for him, that a lot of these concepts and things they're asking him to do here in this offense, they'll ask him to do at the next level.
Safe to say it's a matter of months.
Right.
Teddy Bridgewater's on track to earn his degree in December as well, at the end of his junior year, midway through his junior year. On second down, Bridgewater to the outside, that's Eli Rogers.
Florida, at the University of Florida, recruited down there, and knows the territory extremely well. He's brought them up here to Louisville in a very smart move.
Third and one, shifting two tight ends. Motion.
Fullback there, I think, got a little bit antsy.
Ball start, offense, number 46. It's a 5-yard penalty, and it remains third down.
That's Lamar Atkins, who just moved from line.
This is where Teddy Bridgewater is so dangerous, because if you try to blitz him, he finds the mismatches. He knows where to go with the football.
Knights show pressure. Picked up, Bridgewater hit as he throws to the end zone. Touchdown, Eli Rogers. Teddy Bridgewater takes the hit and delivers his 19th touchdown pass of the season to his best friend from Miami, Eli Rogers.
That's exactly what I was talking about, Carter. UCF brought 7 guys, all 3. I don't know what they're looking at here, the officials.
A previous play is under review, apparently.
Let's see if Eli Rogers did come down with it. And it looked like a layup. You can see it scored out at the end there. You see where they might want to take a look at it, but sure, look, he had possession when he went to the ground. And then after he's rolling over, it looked like the UCF defender kind of knocked it away from him.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Touchdown.
Carter, back to what I was saying, you're in the perfect spot every time.
UCF on the opening drive throws an interception in the end zone. Teddy Bridgewater and the Cardinals make sure they get in the end zone on offense. On third down, Bridgewater, a perfect 3 for 3, including the touchdown strike.
I'm not surprised at all that you know that.
Yeah, Jim James in my morning jacket, not many better. Opening touchdown drive for Louisville. 5 of the 7 opening possessions this year for Louisville. They have put it in the end zone. Central Florida coach George O'Leary said, the key to this game is we have to withstand the early onslaught by Louisville. An interception in the end zone. Cardinals get a touchdown. This is stand back from the goal line. And stand back, knocked out of bounds by the Black Bear and Danny Cannell, Allison Williams, for your Friday night matchup. UCF, Central Florida, against the undefeated Louisville Cardinals. Blake Bortles handing off to Williams.
Josh Boyd, should be a fantastic quarterback matchup, though.
The home team has won the last 6 meetings, and yet Florida State on the road favored against the Tigers. Bortles looking for a screen, comes back the other way. That's complete to Josh Reese.
Side of the ball, but he better be careful because it's coming on the defensive side of the ball right here.
Bortles pressure. A 3 and out.
They take up so much of your attention. That time it was the inside, the interior of the defensive line that got the pressure.
Nearly got the punt block too. Caleb Houston's punt hits inside the 30, down by passing game.
He really does. You talk about throwing guys open. He's got great anticipation, and he puts just enough touch on. He's got that. It's really something you can't teach either. Just a knack that he's got for laying that ball out there for his receivers.
Now 19 touchdown passes against only 2 INTs. One of his INTs was late in the first half. Deep ball against Rutgers last Thursday.
You take that risk, you're giving up matchups on the outside, one-on-one, and nobody makes you pay more than Teddy Bridgewater.
Toss left for Dominique Brown. The junior missed
and winning. Only losing by 3 to South Carolina in a very tough, hard-fought loss. They've got a good squad.
Knights show pressure on first down. Louisville picks it off, leaving a wide open Ryan Hubble to take it. 9 for 10 now from Bridgewater. Dominique Brown on first down. 1:24 to go in the first quarter, and yet if Louisville goes up 14-0, it would be a big blow for the Knights' upset chances. Fake the toss. Bridgewater rolling, throwing complete, fumble. Hubble makes the grab, fumbles it, and now a discussion about where it went out of bounds.
But the ball would have gone out the back of the end zone and hit the pylon when Hubble fumbled it.
Fumbled forward out of bounds will be brought back to the spot of the fumble, and it'll be a first down.
That's a big break for Louisville, because if that ball had gone into the back of the end zone, watch a look at Hubble as that ball is coming loose.
So the fumble out of bounds rule is meant to give the advantage to the defense who creates the fumble. That's why they say when it goes out of bounds, bring it back to the point where it was fumbled. But Louisville
forward and it hit the pylon, which by rule is a touchback. The ball will be placed in the 20-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for UCF.
That was just moments ago during commercial break. So just as Dave Kataya explained, yep, that pylon makes it out of bounds, therefore it's touchback. And give credit to George O'Leary for taking the timeout so that the replay official had an extra look at it, decided to take it under review, and UCF gets a football.
It's questionable they get up there, because if you run a play, they can't go back and review it.
13th takeaway of the year by the UCF defense. Blake Bortles and the Knight offense with the seconds ticking away in the first quarter. That's complete. Josh Reese. Sneak. Really close. That's the 6'4", 230 quarterback, Blake Bortles, sneaking against a terrific defensive line for Louisville.
Louisville had everybody and their brother up in the gaps to make sure that UCF didn't get an easy quarterback sneak in that situation. It was such a sh- short distance for UCF to go. Look at everybody up in the gaps. And they just shut it down right there. I'm surprised UCF didn't have some kind of backed up in their own territory, too. They got him.
Did they get him to move? Certainly there was contact.
Offsides, defense number two. It's a 5-yard penalty and a first down.
You've got to be smarter than that. There is no way UCF is snapping that football. Back there, they were going up there specifically to try to draw them offsides.
So the 4th-and-1 hard count works for Central Florida. This is Storm Johnson, who
keep track of score in Little League and soccer games. Well, there always is a winner and a loser.
On 2nd-and-9, complete. That's Storm Johnson out of the backfield. Stays in bounds. 3rd-and-1, they didn't get it on 3rd down the last time. Had to go to 4th down. Storm Johnson has the 1st down this time into Louisville territory. And now junior from Loganville, Georgia, who was a huge recruit at the University of Miami got. Play fake on 1st and 10. Borders pressured, throws incomplete. Knocked a 3-point loss by Central Florida against South Carolina. Stand back, the true freshman. Pressure incomplete. Intended. Louisville almost blocked the last punt. Houston wants this one a little into the end zone. It is a touchback. Michael Dyer is now in at running back for Louisville. They'll rotate between Perry Brown and Dyer, the former Auburn standout. And here is Michael Dyer on 1st down. Picks up a few. Takes
him that he had in the national championship game against Oregon. Looked like he was down, rolled over to the defender, and kept moving.
Shifting tight ends. Quick drop, quick completion. Copeland wrestled down by
Jordan, too.
And Louisville's a perfect 3-for-3 on 3rd downs. Rolling on 3rd down. Bridgewater looking for a block, throws it at the last second. Parker makes the grab right around the stick. Waiting for a signal.
Parker didn't know what hit him. I think he thought Teddy Bridgewater was going to run it, and it hit him in the belly like he wasn't ready for it. Watch Devontae Parker. Teddy Bridgewater, you think maybe he's going to run for it. Then he flips it at Parker, who's shocked by it. Hits him right in the chest. He's got no choice but to catch that one.
So Bridgewater was out of bounds before the pass is completed. It's 4th-and-2. So it was Bridgewater who was out of bounds. And here's Ryan Johnson. Just hit it a bit, but gets a good roll inside the 30. UCF football in a 7-0 game. Storm Johnson, nothing to.
North has been the mighty North up to this point, but man, UCLA has that feel of something special going on out there.
Bruins have a chance to play themselves not only a Pac-12 contention, but I would contend national championship contention with the next 2 weeks with the check down. Storm Johnson shakes his way for a 1st down and more. Tripped up inside the Louisville 45. 1st and 10, Knights. Stand back, the true freshman with Bortles. Stand back will take it. He spins out of a couple tackles to get to Miami. Now he's a Knight. Play fake. Second and three. Pass complete. First down.
You see. Can help your tackles. That's one of them. Get rid of the football quickly.
Cardinals show pressure. There's a flag.
Start offense, number 28. It's a 5-yard penalty, and it's a first down.
The other to get UCF into Louisville territory, still on the bench.
Comes pressure.
Incomplete.
Board. We're talking about the big guys that we're going to have to block. Created an unblocked defender coming free at the quarterback.
Vance Bedford says, we are a pressure team.
From that look, I don't think he likes this defense he called up. I don't know.
Time to throw for Blake Bortles. Now he has room to run, and Blake Bortles goes scrambling inside the 20. He has a...
About Blake Bortles, but they should.
Both guys are finalists for the Johnny Unitas Golden Arm Award. Unitas, a Louisville alum. That's Rennell Hall, who takes the handoff and fumbles. Scooped up, recovered by Central Florida. Stand back falls on top of the fumble by Rennell Hall.
Well, fortuitous bounce for UCF. Bounce right up into stand back's hands. See, it happens so much when running backs try to get those extra yards. They got to secure that ball, but stand back right there at the right time. Trying to crawl his way into the end zone.
Both of these teams are in the top 10 nationally in turnover margin, and yet we've seen two and almost three turnovers in the red zone. It's now first and goal for Central Florida. Stand back, touchdown. UCF is a PAT away from tying it against eighth-ranked Louisville. Just the second rushing touchdown of William Stanback's college career. That was a freshman.
That was a big answer for UCF. It's kind of been a theme of this game early on. George O'Leary said, can we survive the early onslaught? I say they passed that test.
Moffitt gets the PAT. We are tied 7-7 between UCF and 8th-ranked Louisville.
It's a physical game so far. William Stanback taking it on the ground with the answer for UCF.
Touchdown, and he has tied it at 7. UCF has only one win over a ranked opponent in program history, 2009 against 13th-ranked Houston. So the Knights trying to pull off what would be the biggest upset win in program history. Touchback, we check in with Chris Carter. Athletic Conference. In a conference with Central Florida for the first time. This is just the second meeting between these two programs. The last was 1985 when Howard Schnellenberger was coaching the Cardinals. Sonoris Perry, first down, handoff.
Then drove the length of the field. Very impressive response from UCF.
Now can the Cardinals grab the momentum and the lead back? Sonoris Perry. Fumble at the goal line, changed the momentum of the game. Play action. Bridgewater completes. Minimal gain. Allison Williams, your Friday night crew from Papa John's Cardinal Stadium in Louisville. Sonoris Perry tries to get outside. Dropped by Shaw. With a nod to Sports Illustrated. The pistol, Bridgewater throwing on third and 8. It's caught by Eli Rogers. hauls it in, stays in bounds.
Ability to stretch the field vertically with that last pass.
That's a catch on Friday, Saturday, or Sunday. Check down, incomplete.
Into his craft, spending the extra hours in the film room with his offensive coordinator, Sean Watson.
On second and 10, Bridgewater completes again. Third down and 5 for Louisville, trying to regain the lead and regain the momentum in a Friday night test that we expected from the Central Florida Knights. Bridgewater complete, converting again on third down. It's Damian Copeland. On first and goal, Bridgewater steps up in the pocket, eludes the pressure, fires, incomplete. Louisville playing with Devontae Parker, number 9, without Kai De La Cruz, number 12. And now Copeland on the sideline. To the end zone again. It is caught for a touchdown. And there's Devontae Parker again. And a flag down for a late hit on Teddy Bridgewater.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, number 47 on the defense. The penalty will be assessed on the kickoff. Result of the play, touchdown.
Second touchdown pass of the night for Teddy Bridgewater, 20th of the season.
Teddy Bridgewater, Devontae Parker, he's got some weapons, just almost a back shoulder. Bridgewater purposely underthrew Parker there, going through the end zone. If he would have put him on schedule, like thrown him open, I believe that ball would have been picked off. But because he threw him open towards his back shoulder, he's able to make that adjustment for the touchdown.
Two interceptions thrown and a touchdown lead. Kick it off of the 50 because of the roughing the passer penalty against UCF assessed on the kickoff. So an easy touchback coming. UCF football deemed that he had more interceptions than touchdowns. The 2011 Belk Bowl. Less than a minute to go. Blake Bortles completing to Justin Tukes. Sean Moffitt, the UCF kicker, who hit a 49-yarder last year. Motion on the line. That won't help. We know it's a false start, but against whom?
False start, offense,
options.
Number 63. It's a 5-yard penalty, second down.
Yeah,
he had some options.
We have a 10-second runoff. Central Florida, UCF has taken their timeout to avoid the 10-second runoff.
Leaving UCF one timeout.
It'll be a 30-second timeout.
So
they went up to Penn State, beat them up there. They had South Carolina up 10-0 at halftime, lost that game by 3 against a very good team in South Carolina.
And we are going to head to halftime in a one-touchdown game between Central Florida and 8th-ranked Louisville.
Rock that.
That's right. Red, appropriately red sunglasses there for Rick Hancock. Also, he's going to have to carry a big load for Louisville this season. Carter Blackburn, Danny Cannell, Allison Williams back for the second half of Louisville and Central Florida on Friday night. Finally, for Teddy Bridgewater, and one of those was a ball you pointed out, Danny. He was throwing where the defense couldn't get in the end zone. Dominique Brown takes the first down, handoff, keeps pushing. 2 TDs, 0 INTs. It was the fumble by number 83, Ryan Hubble, at the goal line that cost Louisville a touchdown. Play fake on second and short, complete. That's Devontae Parker coming back from the shoot.
Makes a big difference.
That is 7th TD grab in the first half tonight. Bridgewater hands off again. Dominique Brown shakes his way across midfield. Getting the job, release from that job, and a couple NFL assistant stints as well. Plenty of time for Bridgewater to throw. Completes to Eli through 6.5 games. Out of the eye, Dominique Brown. Still rolling right around the sticks.
I don't think anybody in the country puts as more work in the film room on fundamentals than Teddy Bridgewater. And it shows in the results.
Four seconds on the play clock. Here's Bridgewater rolling. Complete again to Eli Rogers again. So like Reed Eubank and Paul Brown, Watson teaches his quarterbacks defenses and coverages first, then they learn the offense. Brown takes the toss. Flag down as Dominique Brown picks up a first down to the 26. We'll check the flag.
Number 7, 10-yard penalty, second down.
He'll drive a coach nuts on the outside.
The 40-yard line, second down and 14 after the hold. Long drop for Bridgewater. Over the middle, Dominique Brown sneaking out of the backfield and delivering. Yard line, second down and 14 after the hold. Long drop for Bridgewater. Over the middle, Dominique Brown sneaking out of the backfield and delivering.
There are different reasons why you run plays, and it's such a help to have that in the pass game.
On third down, Brown shaking his way to the twin. His work ethic, his football IQ, all elite. Pistol on first down, Brown again. Touchdown, Louisville. This one on the ground from Dominique Brown.
Strong. You gotta love the way Louisville came out after halftime. That's a statement drive right there. Grasping control of this game, physically getting it done on the ground. Really impressed with Dominique Brown too with his running style.
For all the talk from us and everybody else about Teddy Bridgewater and the touchdown passes, it is a Louisville team that wants to pound it. Dominique Brown pounds it all the way into the end zone. A two-touchdown lead for 8th-ranked Louisville. Unitas. First and 10, handoff to Storm Johnson.
When they've executed nicely, they've been able to move the ball, and they've made a couple key mistakes.
Heavy pressure on 2nd and 7. Storm Johnson runs through. Incomplete. Opening coin toss and deferred. So bobble on the punt by Caleb Houston. Loose football scooped up by the Cardinals. Sprinting in for a Cardinal touchdown is the true freshman, James Quick. A special teams blunder makes it a 3-touchdown lead for the Cardinals. The redshirt freshman punter bobbles it, fumbles it, and the true freshman from Louisville's Trinity High School has his first TD as a Cardinal, and it comes on special teams. Now, a substitution issue here for Louisville prior to the PAT. Still no timeout called.
Trying to figure out what's going on. I guess everything's okay.
Eventually we'll have a PAT kick from John Wallace. Straight by Louisville to begin the third quarter.
It's hard enough to win on the road, but you cannot make mistakes like this. Caleb Houston puts it on the ground. Louisville makes him pay. The Ville on Friday night, it's turned up.
His kickoff after the special teams touchdown, stand back, brings it to the 25-yard line.
These schools have a live DJ take care of their stadium sound. I think this might be the only one.
It's the first one that we have come across, I believe, on the Friday night tour.
Might be on to something.
And the football team's undefeated. Coincidence? First and 10 for Blake Bortles and UCF. Johnson trying to run away from that hounding.
Good, I didn't know he'd be this good.
Breaking records and Florida State. Bortles throwing on second down. That's complete. Perriman dropped his
Marcus Mariota up at the top because of the performance he had against Washington. There's a reason behind my madness, Carter.
It is madness. Blake Bortles heaving on third and three. That's caught. Rashad Perriman hauls it in. Two. And
previous play is under further review. The ruling on the field is a catch.
Knights trailing by three touchdowns after 14 unanswered for Louisville here in the third. Central Florida trying to get back in it. Bortles hands off to Storm Johnson. Good block on the outside. Johnson cuts it back inside the 10. It will be first and goal, UCH. For first and goal. Under six to go in the third. Only one touchdown in the three red zone trips for UCF. Bortles complete. Jeff Godfrey.
Because it looked like it was going to get out of hand for a while.
Louisville had allowed only one rushing touchdown in the first six games. Storm Johnson's TD gives UCF two rushing touchdowns tonight. And back in it. Second rushing touchdown of the night for the Knights. Carter Blackburn, Danny Cannell, Allison Williams from Papa John's Cardinal Stadium. It's brought out by Charles Gaines. He shouldn't have been Punt Ruski in that Florida State Clemson game 1988. Plus more on Brett Hundler. Teddy Bridgewater and the Cardinals from inside their 15. Sonoris Perry pushing. Well, of course, we'll see pulling for those chops to come back at some point for Coach Corso.
I like those chops. They look pretty good.
Coach Corso went from here to Indiana. That's Perry. Fumble. UCF recovers. 3:53 to go in the third. And the Knights, down by two touchdowns, have it at the Louisville 15. Perry fumbles. Sean Mag recovers.
Wow, good left hand. You see the left hand by the UCF defender coming up on that tackle. Great strip.
Looks like it was Clayton Gethers who strips it.
And now let's see if UCF can capitalize, because basically UCF spotted Louisville 7 points by the drop punt, picked up, scooped, and scored. See if they can trade off and get one off a turnover.
Motion. Louisville had only 3 fumbles lost in the first 6 games, 2 tonight.
False start, offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Some sort of miscommunication at the line of scrimmage. Seen a couple of those tonight for UCF.
Bortles sets up the screen. This is Storm Johnson again. Johnson reverses field and takes it in for a touchdown. And we're back to a one-score game in Louisville. The Cardinal fumble turns into a UCF touchdown. The Knights come storming back in the third.
What a run by Storm Johnson, too. That play was not designed to go all the way back across the field. Just great individual effort. You can see why he's got the skills to be one-time top 3 running back in the country coming out of high school.
Sean Moffitt's PAT makes it 28-21. Two touchdowns for both UCF and Louisville here in the third quarter. The Cardinals got the fumble on the punt. Harry fumbles it, gives it right back to the
Knights. Watch the screen. Watch the center and the right guard. Watch them. Just follow them throughout the play, because this screen is designed to go to the left. It's a throwback screen. But watch them stay after blocks down the field. Two nice blocks there. And then Storm Johnson takes it opposite field and does the rest on his own. Great.
He's only beaten a ranked opponent once in program history. That was Houston in 2009, when Houston was ranked number 13 in a Conference USA matchup. It'll be the biggest upset win in UCF history if they can hand Louisville their first loss of 2013. Robert Clark from near the goal line. To the 15, we check, but the weaker strength of schedule, the non-power conference, all eyes on the Cardinals. They won by 2 touchdowns last Thursday. We're still jumped in the polls. 14th Street for Central Florida to get back in it. Right back to the air for Teddy Bridgewater.
Look out of the stop. Get the ball back. All of a sudden, they've got this momentum.
Dominique Brown is now in a running back for Louisville. Cardinals rotate backs throughout the night. And this is Brown slipping through that UCF.
Had their eyes set on a national title. A lot of that was ruined by Utah. All of a sudden, UCLA is in the mix. Undefeated, starting to creep up those rankings.
Play action. Bridgewater heaves it long for Copeland. Incomplete.
This is on a shot play, too, down the field. And so efficient tonight.
Night show pressure. Here they come. Bridgewater tipped and incomplete. Louisville's been terrific on third down, but they've been third and short. This is 3rd and 10. With the Knights showing pressure. Bring 4. Here comes Plummer to set Teddy Bridgewater back at the 16-yard line. Florida will get the football back. Less than 2 minutes to go in the third, and it's a one-score game. Fair catch called for. And grabbed by
Noise.
Bortles pulls it, throws complete. That's Rennell Hall, who left the last series for UCF. We have both of the last touchdowns for UCF on a run and a screen pass. So it's Standback, the true freshman, shaking outside. Williams Standback, knocked out of bounds around the 10.
Physical, they've come up and they've hit Louisville in the mouth and fought their way back into this game.
First and 10 from the Louisville 12. Standback again, picking his way inside the 5, touchdown, Central Florida. And UCF is a PAT away from tying it after trailing by 3 touchdowns in the third. The Knights are on the verge of tying it up with 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. The defense steps it up on Teddy Bridgewater. The offense gets into the end zone again, and we are even at 28.
Wow, credit to the UCF offensive line. Watch the pulling center and pulling guard. Watch them come out. Watch the action. Watch the blocks on the outside that they get. Putting both Louisville defenders out of the play. Credit to this UCF line. It's a veteran group of guys. Man, that's perfect textbook power running game right there by UCF.
Best, maybe the best.
This is probably their best test of the season right here. I said it earlier, UCF's got the resume where they could easily be a top 25 team, but because they're not a name brand or they don't play in a power conference, they don't get the respect.
Well, if they win this one tonight in Louisville, now can Teddy Bridgewater and the Louisville Cardinals respond after 21 straight from UCF to tie it? Dominique Brown has the first down carry. Only one or two there. The third quarter, 21 straight from Central Florida after back-to-back touchdowns by Louisville extended the lead to 28-7. So they go to the fourth on Friday night. Teddy Bridgewater and the Cardinals locked in a tight one in this American Athletic Conference matchup. To throw on second and 9. First down. Devontae Parker makes tonight. Now we're even at 28. Screen to the outside. Eli Rogers. We check in without.
In general, love the acronyms. Mm-hmm.
Tight end shift on second down and 6. Bridgewater hands off to Dominique Brown, who's dropped in the backfield. Florida, Houston, or anybody else could rise up. They could be going to a BCS bowl game. Storm Johnson again, pushing to the 45, moving.
The crowd's trying to get up. They're trying to make it a challenge for UCF.
Cardinals blitz on first down. Bortles throws complete to the outside. That's Hall in the end zone. Johnson right through the Louisville D, rolling to the 31. Receiving touchdown. He had 2 TDs in a minute 10. Standback at tailback, tackled by Preston Brown.
They have lived up to the challenge here tonight.
Right around Sean Moffitt's field goal range. Standback. Fifth red zone trip for UCF. They're 3 out of 4, getting touchdowns inside the Louisville 20. It's an undefeated season on the line in the fourth quarter. Storm Johnson again. It's going to be third down as Preston Brown makes this. A third down and 7, critical to Louisville's chances of an undefeated season and an opportunity to possibly play for a national championship. Bortles, pressure. Blake Bortles dumps it out of bounds. There's a flag. It's holding against UCF, which impacts Sean Moffitt.
Holding. Offense, number 63. Penalties declined. Fourth down.
From the holding. Now it's Sean Moffitt. He's 6-for-6 on the season. The junior from Orlando from 34. And for the first time in 2013, the Louisville Carter Blackburn, Danny Cannell, Allison Williams, your Friday night crew of Central Florida storming back on the road. Louisville trails for the first time in 2013. Return to the 21-yard.
Him, he's an outstanding coach, outstanding individual, and a great leader for this program at Louisville.
Screen, Copeland. Both teams full complement of timeouts. Bridgewater, incomplete on third and five. It was second time on fourth down this year. The undefeated season in the balance on fourth down. Bridgewater. Incomplete, knocked away, intended for Devontae Parker, but here's a flag.
15 yards in the previous spot, first down.
Bridgewater saw press coverage on the outside. There's number 38, Ozerites. That right hand wrapped around that waist. See it draped around the backside of him. I do think he had contact before that football got there.
One to go. Cardinals down by three. They've got it from the 35. So from here, if you're thinking field goal, it would be 52 yards. Trying to work to give John Wallace a better chance to tie it. If it comes to that, obviously the Cardinals would rather get in the end zone to regain the lead. Flag on first down, couple of them.
Holding, offense, number 53. 10-yard penalty, first down.
So good call by the officials.
Followed by a hold on Jake Smith to make it first and 20. Back out to the 45, outside of field goal range. Bridgewater check down. It is incomplete. To end the undefeated season championship aspirations of the Louisville Cardinals. On second and 20, complete. That's Michael Lee Harris.
Comes that much more critical.
It would be a 47-yard field goal attempt from here. Bridgewater pressured. He will scramble, toss, complete. First down, Dominique Brown. A chance to tie it, but Bridgewater and the Cardinals want to get in the end zone to grab the lead. First and 10. Bridgewater hands off. Dominique Brown shaking his way all the way into the end zone. Touchdown, Louisville. Cardinals on top. The undefeated season lives on. At least for now.
Dominique Brown, did he tiptoe his way on the sideline? Anything out of bounds? Nope, clearly inbounds for the score for Louisville.
Who missed all of 2012, medical redshirt. Back in a Cardinal uniform, it's this crowd. 3 minutes to go, two timeouts for the UCF Knights. Wallace's kickoff goes for a touchback. UCF has two timeouts. Bortles throws complete. It's the tight end Tukes again, fighting to the...
A lot of those teams are going to start falling because they're playing each other.
Next year, Louisville will be in the ACC. Bortles on second and five, complete. That's Josh Reese, still rolling inside the 30. Josh Reese. Clock rolling again. Bortles, slam, caught. Godfrey, inside the 20-yard line. Less than a minute to go. Bortles, incomplete. To hand Louisville their first loss of the season and give the Knights their biggest win in program history. Bortles to the end zone. Nobody there. Play clock to four. Bortles complete. That's Reese. First down. Inside the 5-yard line. First and goal. 38 seconds for UCF. The Knights have one timeout remaining. Bortles will spike it here. 33 seconds, second and goal.
With Storm Johnson been the workhorse, they can run the ball with a timeout.
Here's Storm Johnson. Drop short of the goal line. 27 seconds. Lorenzo Molden makes the stop. George O'Leary uses his final timeout. It will be third and goal. 27 seconds left. 5 of 7 for 64 to set up third and goal for the Knights.
If you do throw it, though, you want to make sure you throw it in the end zone. It's either a touchdown or an incomplete.
Third and goal from the 2. Bortles rolling to the end zone. Caught! Touchdown, UCF! The Knights grab the lead with 23 seconds remaining. Jeff Godfrey makes the grab. And Louisville's undefeated season is in serious jeopardy once again. The Knights lead with 23 seconds to go. A historic drive for Blake Bortles and the UCF Knights. Moffitt's PAT wasn't pretty, but it sneaks through, and it's a 3-point lead for Central Florida. 23 seconds left. The Cardinals still have 2 timeouts.
UCF goes with a little sprint option pass. You see Godfrey, number 2, just slips behind the defense. Everybody was thinking, up, we're going to come up and attack the flat. Godfrey, the former quarterback, gets behind the defense. Boy, you can see his own receiver, Ronnell Hall, almost jumped up for that. But what a drive by Blake Bortles. George O'Leary likes what he sees. Remember I told you about Blake Bortles being calm, confident?
Kickoff is going to barely sail into the end to the UCF 35 with 23 seconds left in order to give John Wallace a chance to tie it. Teddy Bridgewater pumps. Clock rolling, 15 seconds, 14. Bridgewater forced out of bounds from John Wallace. The Louisville coaches told us he's good from 50 plus tonight. They want to give him a chance. Bridgewater checked down over the middle of the field. Dominique Brown across the 50. Has to have a timeout. 5 seconds. 4 wide receivers for Teddy Bridgewater. 5 seconds left. 1 last shot for Bridgewater and the Cardinals. the deep ball all the way to the end zone. It is knocked away, and Central Florida hands Louisville its first loss of 2013. The biggest win in UCF history, upsetting eighth-ranked Louisville. Final score, Louisville 38-35. Still more to come from Louisville.